This is a short video to explain drag force and provide an equation for calculating it. Let's start with a definition of drag force. Drag force refers to the force that opposes the motion of an object as it moves through a fluid, where a fluid is a liquid or a gas. Examples of drag force are air resistance on a baseball as it flies through the air, and water resistance on a boat as it moves through the water. The direction of the drag force on an object is opposite the direction of the object's velocity relative to the fluid. When a fluid flows around an object, like this picture of air flowing around a baseball, it may form eddy currents and other phenomena that affect the magnitude of the drag force. This is why car manufacturers design cars to be aerodynamic, and golf ball manufacturers put dimples on golf balls. Other factors that affect the magnitude of the drag force are the cross-sectional area of the object, the density of the fluid, and the relative speed of the object. All of these factors are expressed in the following equation, where C is the drag coefficient, which represents the aerodynamics of the object. The drag coefficient is unitless. The next symbol is a Greek rho, which is the density of the fluid in kilograms per meter cubed. It's common in science to use a rho for density. And then A is the cross-sectional area in meter squared, which is the largest area of the object perpendicular to its velocity. For example, if a baseball is moving to the right, then its cross-sectional area is here. Or if a truck is moving to the right, then its cross-sectional area is roughly here. Okay, let's go back to the equation. The last variable in the equation is the speed of the object relative to the fluid in meters per second. Now let's apply the drag force equation in an example and explain the term terminal velocity in the process. A 5-gram rock is dropped from a cliff. Find the rock's terminal velocity given the following information. The rock's drag coefficient is 0.7, the density of the air is 1.21 kilograms per meter cubed, and the cross-sectional area of the rock as it falls is 5 square centimeters. So let me first explain what terminal velocity is. Here's the rock as it begins to fall. The forces acting on the rock are air resistance opposite the velocity, and the gravitational force pulling it down. The net force on the rock at this instant is down, so the rock continues to accelerate down. As a result, a moment later, the velocity of the rock will be greater, which means the air resistance force, or drag force, will be greater. This will continue until the velocity has increased to the point where the air resistance force is the same magnitude as the gravitational force. At this point, the net force is zero, so the rock stops accelerating and the velocity remains constant. The velocity at this point has reached a maximum value for the falling rock, and this maximum velocity is called the terminal velocity. Any object falling through a fluid, like air or water, will reach terminal velocity if given enough time. So now let's solve the example problem. We can solve it with Newton's second law. I'll use the usual coordinate scheme and apply Newton's second law in the y direction. Applying the forces to the left side of the equation becomes this. And plugging in the equations for the drag force and the gravitational force, the equation becomes this. And now we make the important recognition that since the rock has reached terminal velocity, then its acceleration must be zero. And so now we can solve this equation for velocity and plug in values and find that the rock's terminal velocity is 15.2 meters per second, which is around 34 miles per hour. Just FYI, if we drop a rock like this, it would probably take about 6 seconds for the rock to reach this terminal velocity. So there's the example of finding terminal velocity and an application of drag force, and so that's the end of the video.